I thought I'd create another video, as a lot of people on various forums ask about what sort of radio do you put in the Stag. So I just have a regular $100 system. A couple of things you might want to get is James Paddock Room Brothers has this basically an adapter that takes the original DIN, whatever size that was, into the new modern size system. It is a bit tight in there. Some people use right angle connections at the back side of this thing. This unit has a CD. I don't know why I keep getting a CD player, but I have an old set of CDs. So that adds to some of the depth, but I think this adapter from James Paddock actually takes care of that. But it is still a bit tight in the system. Now this is about $100, got Bluetooth, USB, what have you. You know, we don't have DBS or whatever you guys have in UK, but anyway. In the front, I have a retro sound speaker. That seems to be the most common speaker that most people are recommending to get. I had to actually feed it through the glove box. This is a left-hand drive car. I had to feed it through the glove box, and as you can see, it's only held in with two anchor points, but it's okay. I also had to put a on the bottom of the speaker, I just put a little bit of material so it doesn't keep rattling on the heater element or the blower. And so, you know, I actually hooked up this speaker by itself, and I feel that it's quite lame. So this is just the speaker. It's a left and right channel. In the back, I actually have a, you can't see it, but it's literally, it's sitting behind the back seat where the soft top frame sits. It's a powered subwoofer. Again, that was about $100. I didn't have to make any holes in the cubby holes. I am a sort of 80s guy. I like to listen to pop music from my childhood. And so, you know, there's certain songs with a bit of bass. And so since that speaker actually, this particular speaker can be configured as a subwoofer or a speaker. So I have it as a speaker. And then all it's left and right channel as well. And then all you do is just basically balance the controls using this. This radio is definitely a bit more challenging to use compared to my other ones. Got too many buttons to try and configure balance and whatever, but I just turn it up and whatever. So let's just give you, you know, if you're a Haley's, what's her name, I forget, I think it was an Eurythmics copy cover. And but as you can see, if I crank it up, I don't know if you can hear the bass. So my other Stag, which is over there, that has an interesting setup. I put a 3.5-inch speaker in the front. I have a subwoofer also, subwoofer speaker in the back. That's one channel. I have a amplifier sitting in the underneath the passenger seat. And so what I do is I balance that between, it's really a left and right channel instead of back and forward, left and right. The front is left, back is right, and then I can balance the sound from there, you know, more bass, less bass, whatever. It works well. That actually was a cheaper, no, actually I would say this version was cheaper, less wiring, since it has an enclosed power amp. That one has a separate Pioneer amp, but anyway, it gives you an idea of what I did. You know, probably maybe $300 you can get a system plugged in. I think this adapter is definitely something you should consider buying. You know, it's already, someone's already made it. You don't have to bother about it, and just slip it in. Saves you a lot of time and effort.